skiing. It's an attack when the guys are turtle down. So you can get a turtle any way, escape that. Or you can escape from side mount. You can do the same thing on the far side of the head for self-escape. Guys, it's being self-escape to get a turtle and then attack is not very right. The catch with guillotine is different because the arm's on the side and has a lot more pressure. Alright, so just you're starting from the turtle. I'm usually here. You know, you wouldn't even work if you're here, but you're a little farther back on the guy. So if I'm up here and I'm Donkey Kong in his head and hammer fisting and doing all that, you know, usually I'm slid in here, so you might throw a hook in or whatever, you know, switch knees. But sometimes just tap the guy out, especially if your corner's yelling 30 seconds to the end of the round, as always. Finish it with a submission. Sometimes wrestlers don't want to go for submissions because you might lose position going for ankle locks and guillotines and stuff like that. But last 30 seconds, man, you should be trying to finish the guy, get that bonus, because that's where the money's at. Right? So all you do is a catch a guillotine, like accepting him into you. That's why I call it catch a guillotine. Throw this over, go in here, slide your right knee here in tight. Okay? This high on the back to stop his, you don't want him to like shoulder roll out. Bring the right knee across with tight shin pressure, and then tap.
Like that.
Okay, show the techniques. So there's pressure. Now payback's tap. There's pressure with your shin. Okay, yeah, you can stuff this and kind of work out. But there's so much pressure, you should be able to tap the guy before that happens. If it does happen, if you're advanced, you follow him. CB Dalloway style, roly-poly style, keep going and get the choke.
I love that.
But usually there's so much pressure. Even when if he starts to stuff this to work out, you're tapping the guy already.
One more time.
Okay.
What's the difference with knee position, guys?
Instead of here, you know, instead of being back here on him, I'm usually in here on this side because I like to punch the guy in the head. I think punching the face is a very ancient secret technique that works really, really well throughout history. Okay, so go with the punch in the face technique. Keep it simple, stupid at some points, and then kill the guy when he's hammered with more advanced stuff. Reach over. I call it a catcher because it's something like this. You know, maybe kind of almost like a Peruvian necktie stuff. Okay, here, catch. I just like this on all my guillotines, whether that thumb digs in his neck or his artery. I just kind of always grab this. If you want more advanced, turn up the volume. That takes up all the space. Okay? But here, catch. Slide in. And here. This is one of the moves I just worked with Paul Harris, UFC fighter, who was showing this at the seminar. You know, you could get here like Ryan just showed with that underhook escape.
He's coming. Yeah. Here.
Is that right? No, not at the first one. I'm just showing how to get a turtle. Just see that. Give me a north-south. You know, north-south escape could be something like a bump coming to the far side head. Slowing up. Boom, we're in turtle. So, right, guys, get a turtle. The difference is the arm's in. It makes a lot more pressure. We'll find out in a second. All right, catch your guillotine from turtle.